I'm Michael Joyner. It's my brother, Rusty Joyner. So basically, my brother had been trying to get me to come here. He actually got me in a rehab back in 2012, and it didn't work out.
I was driving my kids to school at 7 o'clock in the morning, and I heard a radio commercial, and it was about a good landing, recovery. And it was so powerful, I kind of pulled my car over, and I just listened to it. I was like, wow, man, that sounds incredible. So I typed it in my phone, got back to the house, went to the basement, to the gym, and I opened the website, and I watched the video. And I'd seen lots of videos, because I'd searched, like lots of families do. And something about the video was just so true. It was peaceful, it was loving, it was kind. It was almost too good to be true. There was nothing forceful and aggressive and military, all these things about it. It was just the word of God. It was Jesus and Jesus' love. I thought, if I was struggling and I were not, and I had nowhere to go, that's where I'd want to go.
And ever since then, he'd been trying to get me in. Took a couple of months, but he finally got a hold of me and convinced me to come. And needless to say, I was about 120 pounds coming here. Get stiff wind to blow me over. It was pretty bad.
So in fifth grade, he was 5'5", like 130. He could bench press 225. He was like a phenom in fifth grade. And so he was this legend, and I was always Mike's little brother. We grew up with a single mom in the 70s, so there wasn't a father figure in our home, and Mike was my father figure. And, you know, as I grew older in life, I always thought, how did he figure it out? How did Mike, how are you so strong and so independent? I was just fearful and scared. So Mike was my hero growing up, and I learned everything about being a man, masculinity, being tough, being brave from this guy right here. And somehow along the way, I kind of trace it back to 12 to 15 years ago is when substance abuse and pills and all the crazy things came into his life. And then we just kind of lost that relationship. And when, you know, drugs and alcohol take over, everything changes. And so for me, watching how families on our side of it struggle, but I tried to look through the lens of what he was always experiencing, because he's my brother, he's my family. But for 12 years, even though bad things happened, I always knew that wasn't my brother, because I knew Mike before the drugs and alcohol. I knew who he was before. And so all the crazy things that he said, the crazy things he did, I knew that once we got that out of his system, that same Mike was still there.
You know, it's been a very, very long, long time since I actually used my brain for anything good. It's just, it's amazing how all those feelings, all those ideas, and how your brain just starts working. I'm extremely grateful to be a part of Good Landing. And one of the things I noticed early on about Good Landing is the environment, the structure, what they do. You know, they keep you busy. You go to groups, you do Zooms. You know, everything from the clinical side, you know, to what you need. I was able to detox here. You know, I made a lot of good friends here. I'd never been introduced to God. I'd had no spiritual life. I think I went to church maybe two or three times when we were younger. So, you know, it was new for me. Good Landing is just, it saved my life. I mean, where else can you learn about God, work out, get your body right, get your mind right, clean out the junk? Every aspect of this place is on point, and I love it.